We've recently completed what's titled the Colorado River Basin Water Supply and Demand Study. It was about a 3-year effort, and the objective of that study was to project how water supply and demand may change on the Colorado River Basin over the next 50 years. Supply is decreasing, especially when you consider the impacts of climate change. You're seeing about a 9% decrease in our long-term future average compared to what we've historically seen on the basin. And then we're also seeing an increase in demand, ranging from 18 million to about 20.5 million acre feet of total Colorado River demand over the next 50 years. What's driving the demand is really population growth. So we're seeing population in some cases double under certain scenarios, and that really causes major increases in demand for municipal and industrial water. We're also seeing changes in water use efficiency. We are getting more efficient over time, but that's not counteracting that growth in population. A lot of people are projected to move to this area over the next 50 years, and that's really increasing our demand for water. We looked at a broad range of different options to kind of bring that imbalance of supply and demand closer together. We looked at municipal conservation, agriculture conservation, different ways to import water into the basin, so increase the supply. We looked at different options that dealt with modifying the way we operate our reservoirs. We built a water banking scheme for the upper basin that we considered. Reuse was definitely an option. We evaluated up to about 1 million acre feet of reuse for some of the major municipal areas throughout the basin. So here in Arizona, Southern California, areas up in the upper basin, Salt Lake City, Denver. That was found to be a really significant, important piece of what we think the solution is moving forward.